A night of devastation and desperation for dozens of backpackers forced to run for their lives, waking to a ferocious fire tearing through their Bundaberg hostel.
The blaze, an eerie reminder of the tragic Childers hostel inferno that killed 15 backpackers 20 years ago.
In the middle of the night, in the middle of Bundaberg, a backpacker hostel ablaze. For a few heart-stopping minutes, there were fears it could be another Childers, just 50 kilometres down the road where 15 people lost their lives 20 years ago. It certainly looked like it. The two-storey federal backpackers in Borbong Street erupting around 11, flames shooting out of every window. It went up in minutes.
They were pushed back due to the intense heat and smoke in that part of the building.
We are living in at the top of the house, listen to the alarm ringing, then everybody ran out.
The blaze possibly starting in the kitchen of the adjoining Spotted Dog Tavern, one of the town's most popular night spots. The owner today, distraught. 62 people were inside the historic building last night, many asleep, got out just in time.
Senior firemen say it isn't a miracle everyone got out alive. It's because of the training and the lessons learned from the Childers disaster.
They owe their lives to smoke alarms and manager Rowan Hill.
The staff there were amazing, and to get those 62 backpackers out alive, you know, is a great result.
It was feared the blaze would level the entire block, but after six exhausting hours, firefighters stopped it. The facade, all that's left of the federal. Many backpackers from overseas lost everything too.
We didn't bring anything about our things, clothes. We just, with ourselves, in, we ran out because we want to save our lives.
And that's where the incredible spirit of the Bundaberg community has come into play. There's been an overwhelming amount of community outpouring in support of these 60-odd backpackers who have been left with nothing but the clothes on their back. There's been clothing, blankets and food dropped off throughout the city. The 60 involved, well, they've all been relocated to other facilities. Andrew, as for this one, well, it's around 100 years old, so it will be demolished tomorrow because of the structural integrity.
But that response from the community is very good news, Jordan. Thanks so much.